Well, one of the structures in the brain that has been the most closely associated with depression has been the amygdala. The term amygdala literally means almond because this structure has about the size and shape of an almond. And the amygdala is known to be an important brain region in evaluating the emotional significance of different kinds of stimuli, including stimuli that might be represent a threat, or that might have social significance, or that might have reward value. And the amygdala has been an area where we've been able to show abnormalities in metabolism, blood flow, and also responses to different classes of emotional stimuli. So for example, the amygdala is overly active in people with depression when you show them sad stimuli, but it's underactive when you show them positive stimuli, like things that they would be rewarded by, or even smiling faces. And so you see evidence for this differential processing of positive versus negative stimuli in this structure in depression. The amygdala also plays a role then in organizing the emotional experience and expression. And so it gets involved in organizing the endocrine response to stressors or threats, the autonomic response to stressors or threats, and the behavioral and mood response to stressors and threats. And in all of these domains, you can show abnormalities in depression that really resemble a state where you've got an excess of amygdala activity going on. So the stress hormones are excessively secreted in depression. The autonomic pattern is imbalanced in a way that would be associated with an increased amygdala activity. We've got too much sympathetic to parasympathetic tone. And then the behavioral response of social isolation and feeling anxious, tense, is also consistent with how one would respond with an overactive amygdala. Indeed, in humans, when neurosurgeons have stimulated the amygdala, they actually can elicit the whole range of emotional experiences that people with depression will describe.